Our Old Testament lesson is from the prophet Isaiah, the 43rd chapter, reading verses 1 through 7. But now, thus says the Lord, He who created you, O Jacob, He who formed you, O Israel, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I give Egypt as your ransom, Ethiopia and Seba in exchange for you. Because you are precious in my sight, and honored, and I love you, I give people in return for you, nations in exchange for your life. Do not fear, for I am with you. I will bring your offspring from the east and from the west. I will gather you. I will say to the north, give them up, and to the south, do not withhold. Bring my sons from far away, and my daughters from the end of the earth. Everyone who is called by my name, who I created for my glory, who I formed and made. Our epistle lesson, our New Testament lesson, is from the book of Acts, the 8th chapter, reading verses 14 through 17. Now when the apostles at Jerusalem heard that Samaria had accepted the word of God, they sent Peter and John to them. The two went down and prayed for them that they might receive the Holy Spirit, for as yet the Spirit had not come upon any of them. They had only been baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Then Peter and John laid their hands on them, and they received the Holy Spirit. Listen also for the gospel of the Lord. As we turn to Luke, the 3rd chapter, reading verses 15 through 17 and 21 through 22. As the people were filled with expectation, and all were questioning in their hearts concerning John the Baptist, whether he might be the Messiah, John answered all of them by saying, I baptize you with water, but one who is more powerful than I is coming. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fork is in his hand to clear the threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his granary. But the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire. Now when all the people were baptized, and when Jesus also had been baptized and was praying, the heaven was opened, and the Holy Spirit descended upon him in bodily form like a dove. And a voice came from heaven, You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased. Here ends the scripture for this Lord's Day. May it be a blessing to all of our hearts. Amen. Grace to you and peace from God, our Heavenly Father, and His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. I guess I sort of gave it away, the children's sermon. I indicated what I hope will happen here today as a result of this sermon. What I hope happens here today is that on this baptism of the Lord Sunday, you will once again remember that you are baptized. That's about as much theological profundity as I have today. Maybe it doesn't sound like a whole lot, but in the world in which we live, it's easy to forget that we are baptized people. It's easy to forget the gospel that I just read. What a curious pericope it is. What a curious section and splicing of the gospel it is. I mean, on the one hand, it talks about the people wondering about John the Baptist and if he might be him. the Messiah. Might John the Baptist be the Messiah? John's straight with the man. He says, I'm doing a baptism of repentance. The one who's coming, I'm not fit to untie the thong of a sandal. The one who's coming will baptize you with Holy Spirit and with power. Zoom! And he's going to have this winnowing effect, this throwing the grain up in the air that separates the wheat from the chaff. You wonder about me, but hey, wait until you see who's really coming. And then after having said that, it omits the baptisms. We don't get the baptism in this pericope. It jumps to the result of the baptism. See, it splices that powerful baptism, this powerful person, this one who is the true and genuine Messiah, to the after story after he's baptized. Look what happens. Jesus turns towards the baptism. That's kind of like a repentance, although it was without sin. He turns away from his ordinary life in middle age, at 30 years of age, and begins his mission and ministry. He identifies with the people in the dirty water. He identifies with the community. He says, I will be here in the mud and muck and water of life with them. And he's baptized. There is a turning towards his mission. And after he's baptized, what does he do? He prays. He's just been baptized. He's just turned towards his ministry, his mission, and he prays. And as he prays, the Holy Spirit of God comes upon him, giving him empowerment in a special way for his special work. And heaven's open, and the Father says, that's my boy. That's my child. I am well pleased in this child of mine. This is a powerful story. This story of the baptism of Jesus. It's a story about prayer. It's a story about the convergence of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit in a special way. It's a story about empowerment to do the mission and ministry that Jesus has come incarnate to do. And it is a story about the Father's incredible blessing and naming of the Son as His Son. I want you to remember your baptism. And I want you to remember that the baptisms that are performed here by this font, the baptisms that you received, some of you, so many, many, many years ago, are in that same sense in Jesus Christ. In your baptism, you are called to serve Jesus and to do your mission and ministry. In your baptism, you have redirected your trajectory. You have directed yourself to be attached to Jesus and to live for Him and in Him. You have joined in His quest to care for the community. You have joined in His advocacy of truth, justice, love, peace, goodness, faith, hope, all those magnificent qualities. You have received the Holy Spirit. You have received God's power. You have received a name, a family name. You are God's beloved child. And in your baptism, God is so pleased that you are that child. Remember your baptism. Remember the Christ that you follow. Remember the power is never taken away from you. Remember that God the Father